Ciao everyone, it's Marchettino. Today I'm visiting Romeo Ferraris with Great Smurf because I'm about to make a dyno run with the car. Exactly, today we're gonna find out how much horsepower this car has. So guys, we just made two dyno test runs and I'm surprised. Well, surprised negatively, because as you can see, the output was the best. 486 horsepower and 612 Newton meters of torque. That's less from what Nissan claims, and the problem is related to the fuel. Now I'm running on 95 octane. It's pretty hard to find 100 octane fuel in Italy. And I'll be honest, most of the gas that you find in Italy is basically rubbish, and then you can see the result. If you don't run a high performance vehicle such as the GTR with proper fuel, you really feel a huge difference when you drive it. And now we're about to fill up the car with 102 octane fuel and see how does Great Smurf react. Right, after several attempts with a more high performance fuel, this is the result. The torque is 632 Newton meters, which is what is declared from Nissan. But the power is 501 horsepower, that's still less from what Nissan declares. And the problem is obviously related to the fuel. Right guys, it's a new day and the guys are preparing the car for one last dyno run. The last time the results weren't that good, mainly because I ran the car for too much time with 95 octane fuel. Today I filled up the car completely with 100 octane fuel. The temperatures outside are a little bit lower because it's winter, and we're going to try again to see how much power Great Smurf is running today. So guys, do we finally made it? Well, let's say it's in part, because the torque this time was 665 Newton meters, which is even more than what Nissan claims. But still, the power this time was 511 horsepower, which is still not the 550 Japanese horses that Nissan claims. So in this test, we have seen how does the GTR reacts with three different kind of fuels. The standard 95, then the race 102 octane fuel, but still it was something like 5 liters, so it wasn't that much to see the real performance with this kind of fuel. And last but not least, the 100 octane fuel that you can find at the gas station. I believe that the dynos aren't always 100% accurate, but still I find pretty hard to always make the car unleash all the power that the factory claims. And today we have found out, that different fuels can really make the difference when you drive it. Maybe in terms of numbers, you may think that the increase is not that much, but when you're behind the steering wheel, you can really tell the difference when you're driving the car with the standard and then premium fuel, because the car feels quicker and much more reactive. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more. And as always, thanks for watching. Ciao.
So this is the last corner that takes you to the main street. Let's see how fast it goes here. It's a pretty long street.